It is the heaviest fighting in years, and militarily, it is one-sided. Israel's precision airstrikes have destroyed the offices of Hamas leaders in Gaza, and they have killed top Hamas commanders. Inevitably, civilians, dozens so far, have also been killed. Meantime, rockets fired from Gaza by Hamas are less accurate and often intercepted, but have killed some Israelis while raining hundreds of missiles down, mostly on Tel Aviv. Israel's prime minister has vowed to increase Israeli airstrikes. Benjamin Netanyahu declared today, "We'll hit them like they've never dreamed possible." The fighting was sparked by recent unrest where Jewish settlers tried to take over Arab-controlled neighborhoods, part of the decades-long dispute over expansion of Israeli settlements. This area in East Jerusalem is considered among the holiest territory by both Israelis and Palestinians. At recent protests, a senior Hamas leader vowed not to leave Palestinians to face the Israelis alone.
Jerusalem is a powder keg for any kind of immediate conflict.
This academic says peace in this area will require compromise and new leadership on both sides.
There have to be leaders that come to power that are interested in solving the conflict, which will inevitably involve a two-state solution.
But the political backdrop is highly unstable. There is a power struggle for leadership among the Palestinians. While Israel's Netanyahu has failed to form a government, opposition parties are closer to toppling him from power. And the international backdrop has also changed. After U.S. President Trump's total support for Israel, Washington, under President Joe Biden, is only now engaging diplomatically, adopting a more traditional stance.
Israel has a right to defend itself. Palestinians have a right to live in safety and security. And the most important thing going forward now is to take down the violence.
To that end, Washington is sending a top official to meet with Palestinian and Israeli leaders.
Many governments don't want to deal with it, right? It is a fault line for instability in the region. And the United States really can't ignore it.
The Middle East has confounded peacemakers for generations, and the worry now is that the conflict may spread to the entire region, pushing the prospect for peace even further into the future. Eric Sorensen, Global News, Toronto.
For Palestinians living in Jerusalem, the latest eruption of violence is devastating and familiar. Tonight, we're getting a picture of what life is like for them in a city that is home to some of the holiest sites in the world and where people of different faiths have lived, worked, and prayed for generations. Freelance reporter Nuha Musle spoke to people about what's inflamed the anger.
One of the major developments during this year's holy month of Ramadan in the old city of Jerusalem was Israeli ban of Palestinian presence inside the mosque and outside of it.
We are very angry. It's a very bad thing to do for Muslims in last days of Ramadan, of our holy month, in our holy place.
To Muslims residing here, Al-Aqsa Mosque is central to their well-being and personal dignity.
For us, Al-Aqsa Mosque is our life, our future, and it's part of our faith and religion. It is something that should not be touchable.
In nearby Sheikh Jarrah, 28 families are brooding over the fate of eviction from their homes of 61 years, built on land which the Jordanian regime has provided for them when they became refugees in 1948.
I lived in this house 65 years, and they want to take me from here to throw me to the street, me and my children and my wife and my brother and my grandchildren. That's not easy, you know.
How do we advance? How do we go forward? How do we resolve outstanding issues that need to be resolved? And if this doesn't come, then it's going to recur again and again and again.
The continued frustration of Palestinians makes them desperate to see change.
Either the occupation will overwhelm the whole country or liberation will take place, either us or them.
However, when a Palestinian woman is challenged about the negative consequences of the rockets from Gaza, hurting innocent civilians in Israel, she justifies this behavior.
We are in Arabic saying, who is knocking the door, he has received the answer.
Noha Musleh, Global News, Jerusalem.